Hey allemaal, ik sta hier bij de stand van Guild Wars van ArenaNet. Ik ben hier met iemand van de crew en die gaat mij eens even uitleggen wat Guild Wars precies is. Hi there, what's your name?
Hey, my name is Martin.
All right, great. I am really interested in this game. Part 2 is coming out pretty soon. Yep. The beta was already released. What are the main differences between Part 1 and 2?
It's a completely different game. It works in a completely different way. And it works in a completely different way through other traditional MMOs that are out there in the industry.
So there's no way of comparing it to WoW?
No, there's no way. So we have a lot of things that we do different than other games out there. So for example, we have no traditional quests. We have an event system in the game which is dynamic. So it's the event system reacts to like what players are doing.
So it's going to be a roaming, dynamic world, right?
Yes, it's a dynamic, living, breathing world, and player actions actually impact on what's going on.
All right. So one of the downsides of these type of gameplay, for me, of course, is I'm getting bored after about a week. How is Guild Wars 2 going to solve that? I mean, you said there's no quests, but what's the goal of the game for people who don't know Guild Wars 2, of course?
Okay. It depends on what you define as fun for you. So we have a lot of PvE content in general, like with the events. So, and especially through the events, like every time you log into the map or any map, it might look different. So there's always something new to discover. For people who like the role-playing aspect of games and like single RPGs like Skyrim, so when you create your character, we ask you a bunch of questions, and these questions like put later starting point of your personal story. And then throughout your story, actually, you will come to points where you have to choose between A and B. So the story branches. So we have this like really long story that goes from level 1 to level 80 throughout all the game for like your personal story. And for those people who are really interested in PvP, who basically like long-term PvP, we have two forms of PvP in the game. We have structured PvP, which is the team-based 5v5 type of sports that like going more into the esports, like competitive reading.
Like League of Legends, stuff like that.
Yeah, like that. And then we have World versus World PvP, which is three servers actually fight against each other on four big maps. So each server has a home map, there's a center map. Then we really talk about battles of hundreds of players, and those go on for 2 weeks.
Exactly. That was my other question, of course, because the somewhat older games, like 2-3 years ago, those servers were limited to like 50, maybe 100 players. Can you tell me something about the hosting of these new servers? Because you said they were free, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Can you tell me something about the servers? Maximum capacity, stuff like that?
Not really, because that's not really my level of expertise. I would have to speculate, and I'm not doing that.
That's not a problem. All right. Anything you'd like to say to the Dutch viewers? I own one of the largest gaming channels in the Netherlands on YouTube, about Guild Wars 2, obviously.
So we know that we actually have like quite a large following. At least in Guild Wars 1, we had tons of Dutch players playing the game as well. So you guys stay as cool as you are, and I hope we see you all in Guild Wars 2.
Alright, jongens, hou mijn kanaal in de gaten voor nog meer updates over andere games natuurlijk. Dit was Guild Wars 2, ik ga het zeker spelen op mijn kanaal. En dat was hem, dankjewel, tot de volgende keer. Bye.